Good evening, everyone. Welcome, and thank you, Dale, for that introduction, that very sweet introduction. I am a native Chicagoan, and yet I moved out to the West Coast for several years. And the landscape, the ocean, the lifestyle grew more on me than I imagined. Upon my return, I did not expect to embark on the first of two Arctic winters with record chilling temperatures and blizzard-like snowfalls, kind of like this evening. Upon seeing the fresh fallen snow, I was mesmerized by the magic of the sparkling snowflakes. And then I found myself frozen, watching the snowflakes fall ever so gently outside my window, noticing how quiet I became. Winter moved in and out. And as I ventured outside to walk on the snow paths pressed by my own steps, I was experiencing a new way to connect with winter than just the playfulness of snow. There was such a powerful void as I sat there, almost as if I could hear the snowflakes share deep secrets as they each nestled into a blanket of crystal white beneath them. What does this cold, sometimes freezing time of year offer us? Why does it fall between the letting go of autumn leaves and the old letting go of autumn leaves and the new growth of spring? What does winter show us about our own need to pause, to be still, and even to venture into the dark? In the last few years, I have begun to see the Midwestern winter with new eyes. At least I try. At least that's the intention. It's the practice. It is more of a path of restoring, renewing, retreating myself, mind, body, and spirit. It's kind of like being in a cave, a place to turn to, into, and gestate. Winter invites us into a cave within the earth. And now I see it as a powerful catalyst, an important part of the cycle of life. And I believe we all can benefit from it. In our society, we tend to think of life as having a beginning and an end, more in a linear fashion, point A to point B. Seasons can remind us how life, how nature, is cyclical. As humans, we are part of nature. We're part of this great circle of life. There's an old movie called The Power of One. One of the main characters, Doc, mentors a young boy and teaches him about life through nature. He says nature can teach you anything. Any question you ever have, you will find in nature. Nature shows us the need for seasons within ourselves. How do you honor winter in all aspects of your life? I believe winter holds great lessons we can all tap into at any time of the season. Winter is a time for deep nourishment. Fall provided us with a bounty to harvest, and as we stored it up, we can now take more time to deeply nourish our minds and bodies with nature's cornucopia. I find myself drawing hot sea salt, essential oil baths, to nourish my body. My stocked pantry, because I love to cook, serves as a sumptuous springboard for simmering stews and soups. I cuddle under a warm blanket to read a book I can completely get lost and satiated in. Even a seemingly simple nap in the cave of winter feels deeply nourishing and restorative. What practices do you find most nourishing? How might you incorporate them into the fold of the season? How do you nourish your physical body during this time of year? Do you take pause from great projects, work, travel, and the hustle and bustle of everyday life to nourish your being? Winter is a time to slow down. I notice how winter is showing me so much more than igloo making and shoveling snow. With my body as nature, I notice the weather, how the cold feels. I listen to what my body says. I need to take extra care to stay warmer. I need to slow down. The other day, I almost slipped off the road. Nature was reminding me to take it easy while driving, literally speaking. Some days this winter already, nature has pulled me completely indoors. I feel like I'm part bear. I even feel the impulse to stock up on food in the freezer and pantry. I'm out of honey, actually, and I need to buy more. Part bear, see what I mean? I call on bear to help me honor my body and listen to what I need this winter. Sometimes I feel like I can never get enough time. And I am learning, the more I slow down and take care of myself, the more I can cultivate a practice of love for myself at this time of year that transcends throughout the year. How might you slow down to meet winter? What happens when you stop to breathe the cold air? What do you notice? How might you free yourself up from daily tasks to slow down and savor the chill that invites you to take it easy? Winter is a time to incubate. Like a bear and a cub in its den, we incubate ideas and new possibilities. These can only be grown and given birth to by allowing the time and space to unfold. Seeds germinate when they grow deep, deep, deep in the soil, in complete darkness, from where they eventually sprout. It's magic. By journeying deep into incubation, we can let our dreams, plans, and aspirations birth. By giving them time to incubate, they can flourish when they are ready, perhaps at a later moment. Nature does not move by force. If a bear cub left its den too early, it might not survive. The same is true for an aspiration that needs time to formulate. How does retreating into the dark nurture our souls? How may stillness and surrender cultivate more powerful incubation? Winter is also a time for introspection. That first Arctic winter upon my return to the Midwest really allowed me to listen, stopping to hear what messages lie at the front of my heart. What tune was whistling through the trees if I stopped to hear? Winter time is a perfect time to release that old momentum and step into the cave of introspection. For me, I contemplate my dreams at night, and I journey with them during the day as well. I begin my day in meditation and centering. The messages in winter echo even deeper in the clear cold. I have found it very helpful to write or journal because through words and sketches, I can formulate better what my heart wants to say. What message, inspiration, or new idea might be on its way. There's always something so magical and has been about winter for me, about snow, and completely being surrounded by my senses in this blanket of white. In the last few years, I've been able to experience the magic and stillness of winter like never before. Even on the darker or bone-chilling cold days, I come back to how I can retreat. It is through the practices that I've cultivated over the years in studying shamanism and stepping onto this path of healing, personal growth, and empowerment for myself, it's allowed me to hold winter in a different way. A Midwestern winter in a different way, because winters are very different in different parts of the world. And here it can be long and difficult. Yet that's what I feel this practice has done for me. We are all able to retreat deeper into the cave. We all are. To a tender practice that begins with ourselves. In so many ways, in so many simple ways, we can honor ourselves and slow down. As we embark on this new year and the fullness of winter, I've realized that as Midwesterners and in other snowy climates around the world, today, for example, in this, I think it's in the Siberia, Russia area, I don't know if anyone heard, it was -88 degrees, and people still venture outside. So as soon as they stepped outside, their eyelashes froze, just immediately. Yet there's something so resilient, there's something so powerful about being human. And we're part of the animal kingdom, as I talk about with the cubs and the bears and the different animals that hibernate, but it's even grander than that, because we have this ability to connect to the divine within ourselves, to connect to the power and the beauty and the magic within ourselves, even in this time of year. So this is actually a gift. Winter is actually a gift. A time to retreat, to restore, to renew our hearts and all layers of our being. And I invite you to nourish and sustain yourselves at this sacred time and space, to let go of the old and to make space for the new way of holding this way forward. Thank you.